tricking us. Just in my windows and sending us goals. My backseat ain't empty, we just left the Fendi. We getting it all over the place. This is why I need the fam. This is why I need.
Hey, you guys, it's Sunshine Vibes with the Have Vibrations. If you are new to my channel, thank you for watching. If you are returning, thank you for subscribing to your girl. Love and light to you all. I hope everybody is doing good today. So I'm going to tap right into these messages and see what messages I have today. Calling on the highest light of protection, Archangel Michael. Give me clear messages for my collective at this time. So, let's see what we have for you all today. Okay, magical gateway. It takes courage and trust to venture into the unknown, yet this is where the greatest rewards are. It's time to step boldly forward without looking back. Okay, some of you all are lifting the veil. Okay, I just heard I was born with a veil. So some of you all can feel like you was born with a veil, right? So you are lifting the veil. You are walking into the unknown here. It might seem like you do not have any direction, but Spirit is saying, take the time to pray, okay? Take the time to connect. Whatever you do spiritually, to stay connected to the divine here. Give me one more. Yeah, flourish, okay? Learn from experience and shed your inner light on any unclear areas of your life or those of others. I feel like you guys are walking into the unknown and there is some type of light that needs to be shined, right? You are supposed to be in a time of flourishing, of growing her. Something about finding balance and discovering your true happiness her. Give me one more. Yeah, precious time. So we have precious time. Experience every moment fully and make the most of every precious time. Be mindful not to waste others' time either. Yeah. See, you guys are, I'm hearing bored. Somebody is bored. Somebody is very bored. Okay, so you could have lifted this veil at a time where you like felt like giving up. Okay, somebody felt like giving up. And then it was like some type of door opened, right, for you to actually seek a higher purpose here. And the door had a light and a key. It was like you already had the key. Okay, you already have the key. It's giving me the energy when people say it's not on you, it's in you. It's something that is already established in you, something that you was born with, some type of gift. And it's some type of light that you are shining her. You are being called to use your time precious, okay? This could have something to do with helping your friends flourish, okay? Just shining a light, being some type of positive aspect her. What else do I want to pull? Yeah, loneliness. Okay, so I was picking up on this song, Lil Wayne, I Feel Like Dying. So somebody could really feel like you're alone here. You could feel lonely. I know that I'm never alone, but Spirit wants you to know that you are never alone, okay? I feel like God is calling you to call on him. Like somebody really needs to talk to God, okay? Because there's something about your happiness, finding out what you really want in life here. But something is over, okay? When it comes to, I feel like there's something to do with you being an empath her and accepting yourself, some type of decision you had to make. Ooh, we have service. I feel good when I can help others. So some of you all could be called to do something for somebody else to make yourself feel better, if that's what you need to do, because you are a beacon of light. So if you're feeling down and you're feeling like you're worried right now, there's something about acceptance here. Spirit wants you to get in the energy of disciplining yourself more, loving yourself more. Clarify service. Regret. I know that I cannot change the past. Yeah, you could regret your past, but Spirit wants you to know that you can't change it. So use your time precious. Like, use your time well. Mm. Okay, spirit guides, angels, ancestors, give me more for my collective. What does my collective need to know at this time for the current energy that surrounds them? So you guys, I'm hearing you are okay. You are not alone. So do not never feel like you're alone here. If you feel like that something is not moving in the way it's supposed to, it's moving. Like, everything's moving at the right time. You just have to let go of some type of regret and let go of the past. You could already be in this energy of letting go of the past. But there is an energy that is like bored surrounding you guys. I just feel this bored energy here. Yeah, downloads and upgrades. So you're getting some type of downloads and upgrades. What did I say? It's not on you, it's in you. Clarity. You're getting a lot of clarity at this time. Okay, when it comes to situations, clarify, you need more. When it comes to your purpose, when it comes to what you're doing here, yeah, past relation issues. So you could feel lonely because you're being guided to let go of the past, and it could feel kind of hard letting go of the past, right? Yeah, unbalanced. There is some type of energy around you that wants you to be unbalanced. Okay, you could be a Gemini or a Libra, but you're a high priest. I'm telling y'all, you, whoever you are, you have clarity, okay? You're getting downloads and upgrades. So with you walking into this magical gateway, it's almost like you feel like dying, okay? I don't know who this is for, but know that you are never alone. You are lonely because God is placing you alone because you're in preparation mode. There's some type of service you're supposed to be doing to help others here. And this is the clarity you are getting when you flourish. When you shine a light and learn from your mistakes, and you're shining a light on other people and yourself. This is bringing clarity, right? There are some type of past relationship issues, okay, that you could have. But Spirit doesn't want you wasting time on this issue anymore. Don't regret your past, okay? It's time to change. Give me more. Yeah, trust no one, okay? I feel like you don't trust anyone because people really did you wrong in the past, okay? They did not give you the justice that you deserved, but you taking a step to go into a new direction, this is where your justice come in, okay? Because you're a high priest, I feel like you already know, like, something's coming. And, like, whenever you feel down, I don't know if you guys ever heard this. When you down to nothing, God's up to something. So God is up to something, okay? That's the energy I'm getting, because even picking up on the song, I feel like dying. I don't feel like this is how you feel. I feel like this is just like a phase you're going through, okay? Somebody could fight depression a lot, okay, anxiety. But know that you're getting clarity. Ooh, set up. Yeah, trust nobody, because there is an energy out here that is bored, that wants to set you up. Somebody wants to set you up because you have clarity. They want you to be unbalanced, but you're not. You're a high priest. You know all. You know what's going on. I feel like you know. A cult. Mm-mm-mm. So there is an occult. There is like a group here that is trying to set you up for failure. Because you're getting downloads and upgrades, you have clarity. I feel like this occult wants you to feel like, ooh, wee. Then we have family trying to set you up. I can't make this shit up. Spell work. This could even be people in your family. Yeah, Spur said there's a hidden hater here. So you have hidden haters here. People that are in your energy that are bored. Because it's giving me a bored energy, like, people are projecting, oh, okay, thank you, Spirit. People are projecting that you feel like dying, okay? People are saying you are depressed. You are isolating yourself from everybody because you are depressed, but that's not what it is. You are flourishing. You have to, what am I? I'm hearing, I'm getting a download again, you guys. The grass is greener where you water it at. You understand that your grass is greener where you water it at. I feel like you're the type of person that is always pouring and pouring and pouring into people. And people want you to fill up in regret because you're pouring into yourself. You cannot change the past. So at this moment in your life, you have to pour into yourself and go through this transformation and walk alone, okay? Every season doesn't need company, right? Give me more. Oh, yeah, there is somebody keeping tabs on you, right? So stay grounded. This is somebody that could be really suspicious in your energy. You could really, like, be questioning this person. This person is, like, sketchy. Karmic partner. I can't make this up. This person's moving funny. Okay? Spirit said, pay attention to how this person moves. Okay, give me one more for this deck. One more. So there is somebody that is trying to set you up. This could actually be a lover. Give me one more. Karmic father. This could be somebody's father, scared to love. Wow. So you have a lot of negative energies projecting on you at this time. Some of you all could have went through issues with your father. I'm getting a very, very narcissistic energy here. This father could have either been abusive, or somebody could have went through a lot as a child, or hearing people argue, seeing someone hurt, getting into fights. Somebody is really scared to love. This is why this person is a karmic partner. If this isn't a father figure, this could even just be a karmic masculine that is a father, right? But somebody is scared to love her. Somebody does not want to see you flourish. Someone wants you stuck in the past and, like, hurt, okay? Know that hurt people hurt people. I feel like this energy really wants you not to even look for love, right? This energy wants you to stay in the energy of loneliness. I feel like what happened was this occult, this group of people, this could be a group of people that turned against you, right? This group of people sees that you're going through a magical gateway. They isolated you so you could feel lonely, but didn't understand you was never alone here. You are actually a service to other people. And when you started flourishing and people realized you're using your time well, they've started to regret how they did you in the past. Now, with this occult, I feel like this occult really wanted to keep you chained to the past. Like, someone really did not want you to move on from the past. They wanted you to have some type of issues here that kept you from moving forward. Okay? Somebody really wanted to see you stuck. Give me one card. Yeah, because you're a star. I'm telling you, somebody wants you to worry. Or if you worry and stop. Yeah, somebody has sexually transmitted demons, okay, or STDs. Yeah, this is definitely a karmic partner here. Give me more. Yeah, this is why it's so important to protect yourself, because people will see that you have a new view of life. If somebody is trying to attack you, okay, with sexually transmitted demons, this is an energy warning here. That's what I'm hearing. Yeah, because you're a leader, okay? You're a leader, not a follower. I feel like you are in this energy. Yeah, you're clearing your energy. I'm telling y'all, somebody wants you to worry about your goals. But I'm telling y'all, you don't have to worry, okay? You're being guided. Oh my gosh, I can't make this shit up. Thank you, Spirit. Almost at your goal, right? A grateful heart. So you have no worries. When you are in the energy of love and you are manifesting from a good space here, you are actually co-creating right now with the universe. That is exactly what's going on. You're entering this gateway alone and you're kind of helping people on the way, but you're still tunnel vision. Somebody is still just focused on their future. You have a new view of life. There is just nothing that this person or this occult can do. This occult cannot touch you, right? Yeah, and you're about to get some type of unexpected love. Or clarify unexpected love. Yes, that's a lot. You're about to have a lot of fun, right? somebody doesn't want you to move on, but spirit is saying keep going, coming back to reality. You are who you are, right? Because he created you in his image. So what someone fails to realize is they can be scared of love, but that doesn't mean you have to be, even with everything you went through. Somebody could be pregnant with twins. Yeah, what did I say? Somebody went through some type of abuse, mental abuse. Use your head over your heart. There is some type of seeds that you are sowing here that you are going to create some type of boss, some team of bosses, right? This is a narcissist, right? You, whoever I'm talking to, you can have a business mindset. Then we have sunshine vibes. So some of y'all could be taking time in the sun, okay, and just relaxing her. Or you need some sun time, right, to give you more clarity, okay? Maybe some of you guys need to do some yoga, right? Stretch your body. Spend like 30 minutes in the sun a day. Yeah, there's some type of soul contract. There is some type of soul contract that you have. And you have a group of people that envy you, envy this about you. Because your life purpose center is around communication, education, and ideas. Not just speaking, but speaking life into them. Okay, so you are creating something and you are manifesting, but spirit is telling you, do not be in the energy of talking too much. If you're going to do it, do it. Speak life into your life, right? I can't make this up. You have people pressed out about what it is that you're doing. Fix my heart to be better, letting go of old ways. Yeah, because you're changing. Yeah, spirit said don't go chasing waterfalls, right? Because you're a wounded healer. Somebody feels left behind, and this is why somebody is attacking you. I don't really like always expressing that somebody could be attacking you, because I really don't feel like you are in the victim mentality, but it could feel like you're being attacked a lot. If you watch tarot a lot, you could feel like you're being attacked, right? My ear is itching. So somebody could be talking about you. Okay, this is a form of their attacks, right? People think that if they talk down on you, that you will stay down. Ooh, wait, my ear is itching like a mug. But what they don't realize is the more they talk, then I just got the damn little Boosie song. And if they hate, then let them hate and watch the money pile up. Okay, this is what they need to understand. Like, people need to understand that you can't hate on people and expect new doors to open for you, right? No, that's not how life goes. These people are going through a dreadful disappointment. Somebody's birthday could be in June, but there is something about connecting with angels here. Okay, there is a Cancer that is out here that is saying they are not happy with you. Or you could be this Cancer. Maybe you're not happy with someone. Okay, clarify, I'm not happy with you. I am confident. Oh, okay, wishing you fall. Somebody is wishing that you fall her. Okay. Jail time, a purpose-driven life. This could be somebody that is like in the streets, but spirit is saying nothing comes to a sleeper but a dream. Somebody is being sneaky in your energy. Mm-hmm. They need to stop, because I don't even want to project, but I feel like somebody's going to get into some type of wreck. Okay, because they did love spells on you. Somebody's name could be green, or green could be somebody's favorite color, but I feel like the universe is telling you to confess your love, because you're manifesting new. So don't stay in the energy of thinking about the past and replaying the past, because the past will repeat itself. Okay, so I'm hearing we're living in the past, present, and the future, right? So spirit is saying be mindful of the things that you think, be mindful of the things that you do, because you can stay in that place of the past if you keep on replaying the same narratives in your head, right? Oh, well, this happened to me. And the healing is a never-ending process. You never stop healing, but yet you are what you think. So do not constantly think about what happened in the past and why you feel so hurt and, oh, my father left me, okay? God is saying he's your father. And whoever you are, if you have father issues or, okay, whatever it is, when it comes to narcissistic men, I feel like a lot of men attack women that they know have daddy issues. And past trauma issues, okay? This is because this makes you vulnerable around that aspect, because you could feel like you need some type of comfort when it comes to, okay, your father not being there. But at the end of the day, God wants you to call on him and talk to him. Go through this magical gateway to actually find yourself, right? Because God is saying he's always been your father, okay? He's been waiting on you, okay, with open arms. And whatever door you're walking into, baby, you had the key since birth. The light is shining on you so you can just walk right through it, right? And you can flourish. But you had it since birth. Okay, so don't let what the past, something that had to do with the past, don't let your past hold you back from a new beginning here. Let me pull some treasure. Okay, spirit guides, angels, ancestors, give me more for my collective. What else does my collective know? And some of you all, this might not be your scenario, okay? Take what resonates. If it does not resonate, okay, email me for a personal reading, or, okay, find another reader if you do not like how I'm explaining this, but this is the download that I'm getting. Some of you all, you could have had your father in your life, but your relationship wasn't close, okay? God wants you to get close to him. It's heavy on God wants you to get close to him. Even when, if you have kids and their fathers leave, I do this myself. Like, it is so important to teach your kids to pray, okay? Because we might not always be here, but God is always going to watch over them. It is so important to teach your kids these things so your kids won't feel like they are fatherless kids, okay? This is just to help them understand that they are never alone. You don't want a child to feel isolated and, oh, my daddy, and oh, my daddy. You don't want a child to feel victimized, because they are child. They are kids. They're innocents. Yeah, some of you all, you could feel like your innocence was took from you, right? Ooh, four of wands. But you're stable. You're happy, right? You have a lot of stability. Ooh, queen of swords in reverse. There is a woman out here, a karmic woman, okay, that is in an occult, that is dealing with some type of karmic person that you are dealing with as well. I feel like this man wasn't even karmic until he kept dealing with this queen of swords, right? I feel like spirit has been guiding somebody to move away from an old narrative, but someone has not moved away from this queen of swords. So this queen of swords is causing a lot of conflict. Clarify the queen of swords. I can't make this up. Ace of Cups in reverse. This Queen of Swords is trying to block a new beginning here. Okay. Ooh, wee. I can't make this up. The Moon. This Queen of Swords is doing magic. They are doing rituals to stop your growth. Like, somebody is doing everything in their power to stop somebody from flourishing, from moving forward. Okay. I feel like somebody is coming from out of a spell. Maybe you are coming out of a spell, and maybe this is what you are awakening to. You could feel like you're dying, but this is because somebody is projecting this shit on you. Somebody's projecting death on you. Somebody's doing death rituals. Oh, Lord. These people are crazy. This woman is crazy. This woman's like, I'm not going to stop until you stop. So somebody feels like you're doing something to them, but you're not. You're literally in a four of wands. You're stable. And this person is jealous of your stability, of whatever you are doing here. I can't make this up. Six of Wands. This person is jealous because you have a lot of success. You have a lot of things coming in for you. And I feel like you don't even really, Queen of Pentacles, you are in the energy of just being mature, okay? You're like her. If I got to, you the type of person, you're going to do whatever you got to do to get shit done. You're following the white rabbit here, and you're holding on to your money, okay? Oh, wait, the Lovers. And you have a lover here. So this Queen of Swords is really jealous about a lover. Ten of Pentacles, the Chariot. Somebody is jealous about your money, about your stability, about the way you look. This woman is like, This woman wants to be malicious and do something very sneaky behind your back. That's why setups her. This woman's trying to set you up. If not you, this woman's trying to set up this masculine that is attached to you. This karmic male. Yeah, five of wands. Somebody wants to compete with you. Okay, when it comes to somebody giving something to somebody, but you're not competing. You're in the energy of being gifted by the universe. Like, literally, look at this. The universe is like, well, you can block this love off of, but whatever else is coming in, you can't block that. Okay, somebody can't block what God already has for you. They can compete, but it doesn't mean they're going to win. This woman really thinks she can defeat you. Okay, clarify the lovers. But you're not even in the energy of competing with this woman because you are in the energy of walking into the unknown, right? I feel like there's a group behind this woman that is encouraging this woman to do this shit. Wow. Yeah, Eight of Pentacles. This person is doing a lot of fucking work. And they're not getting any results because you're still successful. This person is just doing work. Okay? That is not. Somebody needs to understand. You can sow all type of seeds, right? Good seeds, bad seeds. This woman is sowing some fucked up seeds. And this woman doesn't understand. You're going to get karma. This woman's going to get karma. I can't make this up. The Chariot. Because you're too protected. Your ancestors are going to fuck this woman up. Now, I'm just keeping it real. I'm going to keep it a buck. Two of Wands, because you walked away from a situation and you let something go. Somebody doesn't want to let something go. Yeah, Three of Cups, Six of Cups. Something from the past. Somebody doesn't want to let something go, okay? Somebody feels like you're winning. Okay, you're winning, I'm losing. No, you're losing because you're doing magic, you're doing work. If you stop doing this, you might win, okay? But you're not. Somebody does not want to walk away. Somebody wants to keep some shit going, okay? Clarify Two of Wands. The Star. What did I tell you guys? You never stop healing. Somebody really needs to do some root work. This woman could be doing root work on you. Somebody needs to do root work on themselves here. And what did I say about pouring into other people? You are the type of person that just pours into other people, right? This kind of leaves you feeling naked, right? But not knowing that you're healing. You're a healer. You're a wounded healer. You've been healing people since whenever you come in a room, you start healing people, right? But there is something about your energy. It is so healing. It is so nurturing. It is so caring. It's like Virgin Mary here. I'm getting in the energy of an innocent person. Like, you're innocent. Okay? There is no reason why this woman should be attacking you. Clarify the Star card. I can't make this up. Tower. It's going to be towers for this woman that is attacking you when you are innocent. Okay? You're innocent. Somebody's attacking your innocence. Someone wants someone to look at you like you're a Knight of Wands. You're playful. You could be playful, fun, but somebody wants somebody to look at you like you are somebody who is going to block them from moving forward, block them from success. Like, don't go towards this person. This person is doing magic the whole time. This woman is doing magic to keep somebody from selling the Kama waters because someone knows someone wants to go celebrate with somebody. Oh, Lord. This shit is crazy. Yeah, Seven of Wands. Somebody's being blocked. Something's being blocked. I feel like this masculine hasn't even came out here. So I feel like this masculine doesn't even really understand that this woman is a karmic woman. I feel like this masculine doesn't understand that this woman is blocking his blessings. Somebody is being called to block someone, or maybe someone already has blocked somebody. Or this could even be your ancestors blocking out the magic, keeping you from being distorted, okay? From it touching you, keeping your innocence. Yeah, Ace of Wands, I'm on point. You have clarity. This is what is being done. Yeah, Strength card with the Four of Swords. Somebody is stressed out because you're in a meditative state. I'm hearing running for the roses, okay? You're taming your inner. There's something about you popping off because I just heard a lot of, let me, Is it Lotto? Let me pop off. Okay. Somebody is like, they're used to you popping off. They're used to you being a certain way, but you're not. You're like, yeah, I'm done. You're done. You're not pressed. You have a new view of life. You have things coming in for you. You're flourishing. You're helping other people. So why would you be in regret? Why would you? Nine of Cups. You're getting your wishes fulfilled, collective. There is a decision you need to make here. Okay. But whatever decision that you are going to make, it is going to be something gifted. I feel like you're being gifted from the universe for going through this, because this woman had no reason to even attack you. Somebody wanted you homeless. They didn't want you stable. Someone did not want. This is what happened. Whoever this woman is, this karmic woman did not want this masculine looking at you like you were stable. You were successful. You were protected. Someone wanted someone to look at you like you was the reason that things was happening for them. Tower moments, why their work, even this, if this person couldn't work and this person's money wasn't, this person wanted this masculine to look at you. They wanted to distort someone's view of you. But you're untouchable. Like, keep praying, collective. I can't make this up, the Empress. You're untouchable. This person doesn't understand. Knight of Cups, the universe fucks with you. Okay, God fucks with you. Okay, your spirit guides fucks with you. Like, what the fuck? Wow. Let me pull some from my situations deck. Give me one card. Projected. I'm telling you, this person is projecting on you, right? Heavy ass projecting. Because somebody is realizing something. They're coming to the light. Okay? Because somebody is ghosting somebody. Somebody's cut someone off. What if I cut off? Yeah, this could even be... what did I say? Something to do with kids. Children. Playfulness. Yeah, it's divine intervention here. It's divine intervention. Because somebody is doing too much. Okay, somebody is doing too much projection because somebody is focused on you. Okay, you're protected from whatever type of attacks that these people are trying to put on you. This could even be family. I can't make this up. You're protected. Okay, somebody needs to understand you're protected. These people are sad, feeling heartbroken. They feel alone. They want you to feel this way. Yeah, somebody wants you to have anxiety, but this is just people from the past that can't let go of the past because you're a divine film. Okay, you could be cutting people off left and right, and this hurts. It hurts, but what they don't understand, it hurts you. It hurts you. Whoever you are, I'm feeling your energy. It hurts you to cut these people off. But it's almost like I'm getting that energy of don't bite the hand that feeds you. Okay, like it's almost like the energy, like you have to cut these people off because your well is gonna run dry. You're doing too much pouring into other people's cup. And your well is going to run dry. Mm. Yeah, see, you have some type of long-term commitment coming in. Somebody's in their emotions about you. They ain't saying shit right now, collective. But they really love you, okay? They want to come together with you here. Because somebody sees you plugged in. I can't make this up. Somebody is getting a divorce. And whoever this person is getting a divorce with is looking you up. Is searching for you, trying to find out answers, okay? This person's embarrassed. This person is threatened, okay? And gossiping. I can't make this shit up. Gossip. Gossiping. Okay, what did I say? Petty, jealous, envious. Petty and jealous and mad because somebody's in love with you and you're in love with yourself, okay? You're done pouring into people and this woman doesn't understand that. You learn to pour into you. You're not sitting around waiting on this man. Somebody feels like you're desperate. You're pressed. But how are you pressed when you're focused on what God's doing her? You're walking into the magical gateway, walking into the unknown. This woman is fucking with you, right? Because this man's not fucking with her. Wow. Yeah, hamster wheel. But somebody's ready to chase you, collective. Somebody's ready to chase you right the fuck down. They want to talk to you, get on the same page, because this person keeps hearing, having dreams about you, hearing songs, okay? My ear is itching, so somebody is really talking. Yeah, somebody's talking trash, mad shit, okay? Because somebody's letting somebody go, and somebody is, like, begging and bargaining. Yeah, because somebody's going through some type of court issues. But somebody feels embarrassed, okay? Because somebody is obsessed with you. Somebody's obsessed with having a family with you. Somebody's like, I'm not going to stop until they get you, right? Because they have a magnetic pull towards you. They could be avoiding this karmaker. Clarify avoiding. Yeah, they're avoiding this karmic. They're trying to come through some type of settlement, some type of agreement here. This could be today. Okay, somebody wants to offer you something. Because somebody knows that somebody, some type of toxic-ass soulmate that they had, they know they want to be single. Somebody's like, they want a new beginning here. Yeah, because this love that they have for you, being around this karmic, they feel chained. They feel weighed down, right? Yeah, but what did I say? Clearing out your energy. Cleanse your energy, collective. You're protected by Archangel Michael. Okay, give me one more. Yeah, I can't make this shit up. Find the lesson. Discover the purpose in a situation. Trust that you are learning. These people in this occult, they need to find the lesson, right? Because I feel like you found the lesson. When it comes to dealing with this person, this third party situation, sir. And these people are looking at you like, no, we're going to fucking get you. And you're looking like, but I already know where I'm going. Right. You already know that you're on the journey. You're becoming braver here. Okay. You're growing stronger. These people know that you are growing stronger because you're not reacting. Didn't I say run for the roses? Painting the roses red. Okay. Somebody feels like, oh, you're covering up arrows. No, you're forgetting your past. Yeah, clock time, pressure, in a rush. Somebody wants you to feel like you're in a rush, but Spirit said, no, use your time well. Somebody just wonders what will happen next, okay? But pause before action. A moment's regret. Idolizing the past, fearing you made a mistake. Don't fear you made a mistake, collective. You are on the right path. You need to focus on what God is doing here, because your message is for a rabbit here. Somebody just wants to be queen. They want you to forget who you are so they can step in and be you. Somebody wants to be you so goddamn bad. It don't make no sense. Okay, let me get a message of. Give me one from this text for God's ancestor. So we have freedom. I realize my wounds create doubt, resentment, and guilt. So I work to free myself of darkness. I cast off negative thoughts, find peace in my heart, and discover the being of light within me. You are free. Then we have in God's hands. My trust in life is implicit. God's great knowing and greatest love guides my heart and my choices. My faith is steady and I remain true to my light. Everything unfolds according to God's will. What did whoever you are, heavy on God, because Dad came through in this reading today, and he just wants you to know you are not alone. Pray, okay? Stay connected. You are connected. If you feel disconnected, it's because somebody's projecting this energy on you. They want you to feel disconnected. They don't want you to feel like you are connected. This is because someone wants to distort someone's view about you, period. I got a lot of cards I heard. But 444, you are protected from any harm. Give me one more. Yeah, this could be a Scorpio, water signs. Somebody feel like you're a rich snob. There's something about you being an empath. You're picking up on downloads through music. But what did I say? Rituals trying to stop your growth. These people just don't want you to grow here. Anything else in the set? Yeah, 666. Okay, you're being encouraged to refocus your energy on what matters. What did I say? Somebody wants a family with you. Let's make babies. Okay, some of y'all can even get candles, connect with your spirit guides. But somebody's just hating on your money, okay? Haters talking behind your back. I told you they was talking a lot of shit. My ear has been itching this whole damn reading. Yeah, not spiritual. Because somebody is not spiritual, so they talking shit about you because you're an alchemist, okay? You have Egyptian blood ties. Your ancestors, somebody's getting readings done on you heavy. But backfire magic, you was the one, okay? That's all I got for you guys. Love and light. Namaste. Ashe.